Your laptop, your PC is getting shut down or restart sometime. Now, this may be a heating issue. How to fix the heating issue? Before that, how to know that whether it's a heating issue or not? Everything I will tell you in this video. So stay tuned to the end of the video. There may be different issue like a voltage fluctuation issue, like a heating issue. For that reason, your computer, your PC is getting shut down. To know that better, you have to monitor your PC, your laptop carefully. Whether it is shut down or getting restart in a voltage issue, when a voltage is fluctuating, that time the PC or laptop is getting shut down, or when you use for more time, or when you heavy work, heavy use your PC, that time it is shutting down or restarting. That you need to know. First step is fix the issue. Know what is the problem, whether it's a voltage fluctuation problem or whether it's a heating problem. Once we know what is the issue that causing the restarting or shutdown problem, then after that, taking to considering that, we can solve it. Now you have identified that it is a voltage fluctuation issue. That means you need to stabilize your voltage. How you need to stabilize your voltage? You need to stabilize your voltage by buying a UPS. UPS stands for uninterrupted power supply. It is a power supply that give your PC, your laptop a stipulated time when there is a power cut. It will provide the power, or else when there is a voltage fluctuation, that time also it stabilizes the PC or laptop in order to run it smoothly. If your house have inverter pre-installed, then that also work in this scenario, and your PC will not get a restart or get shut down in a voltage fluctuation issue. Now taking to the second point, that when you heavy use, when you do a hard work, heavy work in your PC, in your laptop, that time it is causing a restart or a shutdown. Now if this thing happen, then there may be three condition. Condition one is that you need to analyze which software causing the heating issue, then you need to fix that software or you need to replace that software. Then the point two is that whether your PC, your laptop is getting heated by dust or any other particle that blocking the fan install in it. If that is so, then we have to clean that. The third condition is that you need to change a several parts inside your PC or laptop in order to fix that. Everything I will tell you. So without spending a much money, you can fix this all issue. Now taking to the first point, that you can do it manually. If your system is getting shut down, then you can do it manually. Now I will tell you a software, that link also given in the description. That software you can install it on your PC. Now in that software you can find out that whether your core are getting heated or not, whether your PC is getting heated or not. That software if you install, then you will get a good idea that yes, the shutdown or restart is being there due to the heat. So install it, link is given in the description below. This particular software is Core Temperature App. It measures the temperature of your core, it measures the temperature of your processor. Now there are three conditions, whether your core or whether your processor is getting heated below 60 degree or not. If it is below 60 degree, from 40 to 60 degree, that means your PC is running smoothly. You need to replace a particular app that causing restarting or heating issue that leads to shutdown. Only replace the software, only change the software, and you are ready to go if your CPU temperature falls below 60 degree. Now in the measurement of Core Temperature App, if the temperature falls between 60 to 80 degree, that means your system needs a proper cleaning or proper evaluation that what is causing the issue. You need to open your laptop, open your PC, you need to clean the dust, you need to check whether everything is working fine in a closed manner, whether the fan is working properly, whether the fan is helping to reduce heat or not, whether the fan is causing sound or not. If the temperature falls between 60 to 80, that means you need a proper evaluation and you need a proper cleaning of your PC and system that will fix the issue. Now the third point is that if you measure the temperature by Core Temperature App that is exceeding 80 degree, that is not a suitable temperature for any processor, for any CPU. Now what will happen, the CPU and processor are programmed that way is that if it is more than 80, 90 or 100 degree of temperature, it will shut down or restart automatically. In order to fix that, we need to reduce the temperature. How we need to reduce the temperature? First, we need to evaluate. First, we need to open the fan that is present inside the PC, that is present inside the laptop, and that covers the processor fan. Particularly, okay, you need to open that, you need to clean the processor fan completely. That processor fan is otherwise called a CPU cooler. You need to open it, you need to cool it properly. Then a 10 rupees 5 rupees cooling solution you will get in the market. You put the heating solution on your CPU, on your processor, then install the fan again. Now this way the system will dissipate through the fan easily. This will act as a conductor between the CPU fan and the CPU. Sometimes what happens when you use your system for a longer time, the solution gradually fades away. So the CPU cooler is not helping the CPU to cool in order that there is no contact in between. If you add the solution in between, then the CPU cooler will act as a cooler agent and it will cool the CPU. Now this result a cooler system on your PC that will run smoothly, it will not get restarted. If that solution is not working, then you need to purchase a fan from the local market or online. You need to replace the cooling system completely, and that will result a good performance in your CPU without getting heated, without getting restart. If you find this video is helpful, if you like this video, if you want to watch more videos like this, then you can check out my other videos in my YouTube playlist. So right now I'm signing out from this video. We'll see you in this next video. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye bye.